All right, welcome everybody to the meeting of the Conservation Commission. And first up on the agenda is going to be Yankee Candle's request for determination of applicability for installation of a power line. Ed, are you going to do the presentation?
Sure. Let me try and do a screen share here.
Let me make you a co-presenter or a co-host, then you should be able to do it.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
Let's see, just bear with me here. I'm trying to figure out how to do it here. Share a screen. I'm trying to get to just bear with me, please. Here, Acrobat Reader. Here we go. Share. Okay. Can everybody see my screen share?
Yes.
Okay. Purpose of this project is Yankee Candle is doing an electrical upgrade that involves removing four rich burn natural gas engines called the Tecogen engines, located here at the northwest corner of the building, and replacing them with electric power and new chillers, electric power supplied by Eversource, the utility currently serving this area. And the work also includes a general upgrade to the power serving the building. The original plan was to run power from Christian Lane right straight across the north lot and into the building. And we have changed the plan to minimize the impact on wetlands. So the power is going to come on the two existing poles. I don't know if you can see my hand by on the screen share.
Yeah.
So we're going to, hello?
Yeah, we can see it.
Okay. So the power is going to run from the existing power lines on Christian Lane down the driveway on the two existing poles, and then going to put in a new pole here, shown in green, and a second new pole here, shown in green, and then go underground through a new conduit and run along the south side of the driveway at the north end of the facility, make a 90-degree turn, and then run across the lawn down to the northwest corner of the facility. Wetlands exist pretty much where my hand is, and then we had a delineation completed, which you have on the hard copy, which showed fairly extensive wetland areas in this north lawn, kind of more or less where my hand is showing. So we're staying in the buffer zone to run the new electric utility into the Yankee Candle Company. So that's basically what we're up to do.
Very good. Are there any questions from commissioners?
Do you have to worry where the new poles are about where your septic system is there? Or
The septic system is right here where my hand is. So no, the poles are away from the septic system, but certainly not too far from the hump of the bank, so to speak, mm-hmm. right here, because you can pretty much see where it's more brownish where the actual septic system is located.
Yep.
The leach field. The tanks, of course, are over in here, but that's the raised leach field out here.
Yes.
Any other questions or comments from the commission?
No.
Any questions or comments from the public? So then I guess the vote before us is to issue, I would propose that the vote is to issue a negative determination of applicability without conditions. So let's take a vote and see what you think. George?
Aye.
Ann?
Aye.
Andrew? I'm sorry, Andrew, I didn't get it.
Yes.
Yes, okay. And Montserrat?
You're muted.
Sorry, aye.
I also vote aye, so the vote is unanimous. So we will issue a negative determination of applicability without conditions. It may take a little while for us to gather all the signatures and get it in the mail, but I expect that it will be out to you by the end of this week or beginning of next week at the latest.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to shut down my screen share now. Stop share.
Yep, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, and have a good evening now.
All right. Thank you. That was easy.
Yep. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.
Now I'm going to suggest that we just shuffle the agenda a little bit just to pick up the Long Plains Solar Certificate of Compliance, because I think that'll be relatively brief. And I see that we have Tony and Jen on at the meeting now. I had forwarded to you all, commissioners, the email I got from Tony talking about what had been done. And hopefully you got a chance to drive by there and take a look at it for yourself. I stopped by there this morning. So I guess I would just start by saying that the commissioners have any questions or comments about what you saw. Are we satisfied?
Yes, I think so.
Anybody have a question about that or want to give it a thumbs down? All right, sounds like we're satisfied. So the vote before us is to issue a certificate of compliance for this project without any ongoing conditions. So the vote, George?
Aye.
Andrew?
Yes.
Ann?
Yes.
Montserrat?
Aye.
And I vote yes as well. I want to thank Tony and Jen for their patience while we work through this. I believe that the outcome that we got in the end is better than where we were before. And it seems like it was done in a way that was reasonable from your point of view. So I think I do have a signature sheet for that already. So I should be able to get that in the mail sometime this week. But as far as I'm concerned, we're finished, unless you have anything that you would like to say, Jen or Tony.
Thank you for everybody's work on this. We appreciate coming to a conclusion on this project. And if you could send that to me, Scott, I'll make sure it gets recorded, and then I'll submit a copy back for your files, for the commission's files, and also to Jen. So then we'll be fine with that. So thank you all. Have a great evening.
Thank you very much.
Talk to you soon.
Okay. Take care. Right.
Yep. Thanks.
All right. And now the third principal item on the agenda is the notice of intent filed by Conservation Works on behalf of the Kestrel Land Trust. I am going to recuse from any deliberation on this. So I'm going to go dark, but I'll be listening in the background. So if any questions come up, feel free to prompt me. So I'll.
Oh, Scott, I forgot to prepare for this, so I don't even know what words to use. Can you just be here to help me know what words to use and not say anything?
No, you'll have to rely on George and Ann and Andy for that.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to make you a co-host, Montserrat, and okay. I'm going to make Pete a co-host. In case he wants to share screens.
All right. So I think the first thing would be, Pete, if you want to just go through your NOI and tell us what you are thinking of. You're still muted.
Am I still muted?
Oh, you know, you're good now. I couldn't hear you just then, though. Okay. Maybe you were just moving around.
I'm okay now. You can hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I have to say, you folks are very efficient. If you can do ours in 3 minutes like the other ones, we would be grateful.
We've been working on those ones for months. No, just the driveway one.
Okay, I can put up the map in a minute. And I think Dick is here to talk about some of the details. But just in general, we did have a site inspection the other day. George, Monty, and Andy were out there. And what we looked at were the three parts of the project, which is all really one project. It's starting with the construction of 440 feet of bog bridging from the new parking area at the edge of Chestnut Plain back to the point where the previous order of conditions from last year authorized a 60-foot raised bridging. Then the next part of it is replacing two very small footbridges that are somewhat aged and built on native materials that is not going to last for very long. So our judgment was we should replace those, and using the calculations, the length and the width of the two bridges is going to be in both cases greater than the present setup, so that there ought to be plenty of clearance for water beneath. And then the last project is out of the it's in a buffer zone of the stream, and it's a set of stairs that with a total rise of about 6 feet. And we've done all of these projects in other places, and the materials that we sent in include photographs, and Dick had assembled the detailed plans for each of the phases.
Could you share your, could you just briefly go through the plans? Could you share your screen to do that?
I think so. I remember last time, and it turned out that was the day my laptop died. I never to be used again. So I'm hoping with this new one.
If that doesn't work, you sent it to me so I can share it.
My screen.
There we go.
Okay, can you see the arrow or my little cursor?
Yes, okay. We can.
So starting here on the northeast corner of the property is the 440 feet of proposed bog bridging.
Could you just control plus and make it a little bit bigger? Thank you, that's good.
Not sure how to get to the lower part of the map.
Can you, there's a gray bar in the on the side.
Yeah, I think you can it's under everybody, it's under everybody's faces. So
can you make it full screen? It's okay if we can't see each other's faces.
Change to the hand icon up top.
Okay.
Okay, so what we had originally planned was a 60 foot, I think, or maybe it was 100 feet of raised bridging in here, but that didn't do the job. What we really need to do is get across this amount of semi-wet land that we're allowing as BBW, and the bog bridging that we'll install involves a total impact of 135 square feet. In other words, 1 foot for each of the sleepers that are spaced at 4 foot intervals along the bog bridging. Then it gets to this 60 foot section of raised bridging that we'll be building under the previous order. The rest of the trail continues along this way, and we get to the main existing loop, but we didn't want to use this part of it because it's quite wet, and we didn't want to divert down this way on the other old route, so we followed the existing trail, very small trail that passes these two footbridges, and our proposal is to replace those. And the other day in the field, I had said we'd be using 6x6 stringers. We'll actually be using 2x10s. So it will set a little higher and be plenty durable. And then we proceed to the set of stairs, which is 10 feet from the stream and allows the trail to ascend that short, steep slope without a long switchback and without damage to the terrain.
Okay.
So any questions so far?
Nope.
We have sent the copy of the NOI into DEP, and they will presumably be able to issue a number sometime within the next few weeks. So we're anticipating a continuation until your September meeting so that we can, I hope, get a go-ahead and still be able to build the project this fall for Kestrel. So anything else that you need at this point? I don't know whether Dick is on. If so, he'd be glad to describe more details if you need them, but it's pretty straightforward. So,
well, you just talked about the bog bridging. Well, I guess you talked about all three things. Do we have to decide right now if we are going to approve putting all three things on one NOI? Anyone know?
I said, yeah, I'm just going to pre-talk. Like, yeah, can we break it into, like, parts? Like I said, we have the stairs, the bridges, and then the bog bridging. You want to, like, approve each individual part, I guess, as part of the NOI, break it up into three parts.
Right, that would be another option.
Yeah.
I'm not very experienced in this, but I don't think we have put three things together like this in the past.
I'll say that I hope it can be considered one project. You know, we're contracted to do it as one project, and the expense of three notices of intent, I think, would bump up against Kestrel's ability to do this project.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I mean, just break it up into three parts as of one NOI, maybe. I'm sure that's what I was thinking.
But. So just a three-part NOI.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we can always, if we need to, we can always put separate conditions on each thing.
That's what I mean. If we break it up in three parts, we can have conditions for each part if we need to.
All right. That sounds reasonable.
Yeah, it does.
So what do we need to decide today if we're going to continue?
Well, we could take each individual one at a time. We can say, do we approve what's presented to us, or do we want to make conditions on those or not, I guess.
I think we need to continue it pending what we hear from DEP.
Yeah, I don't think we can until it has a number, a file number.
True.
I remember DEP paid a lot of attention to the culvert on this property. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of back and forth there. So I'd prefer to see what they have to say down there and in their response to this.
What would you like to hear from us today, Pete?
Just, I think, whether or not the information we've provided is enough for you to make a decision. The detailed drawings have been submitted, and the documentary photographs. So we're hoping that will allow you to make a decision. I mean, as I said, this is a pretty straightforward project with typical design. We've done quite a lot of the bog bridging, and it's worked out well, and it's very stable because the ends of each of the 10-foot sections are tied together on a single sleeper, so there's no chance for it to rock up and down and trip people up.
So I think we're all in agreement that you would be able to have it permitted as a single project just with three parts. But none of us have had time to look at that design at all. Would you mind going through that with us briefly? It's not complicated.
My phone just rang as you were saying that.
Would you mind going through? I know there's, I didn't look at them in detail, but I saw that there were, you know, cross section of the design through here. Could you just go through that with us in case anybody has any questions?
Can I put that up on the screen? That makes sense.
I had one question if Scott could chime in.
Can't hear you, Pete.
Sorry.
You hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
And Andy, did you have a question?
Yeah, I didn't know with DEP, because we're doing stream crossings on a couple of these, and would they trigger anything like they have, that you have to have designs presented or something? I know we've done like other projects when they do streams and stuff like that. I don't know if that have to be in there.
We've done, just so I can answer this, we've done a couple of these with Amherst College recently and went through the DEP technical specifications, you know, which require a length that's 1.2 bankful and then a formula that has to be met. And we've met those, and the figures are in the plans. So
I just want to see something like the DEP comments coming back and saying, you know, you have to fix this and this. You know, we've seen that before, you know.
I think DEP will be happy, but Mark Stinson is always quite meticulous, so we'll see.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I'll answer that for you, Andy, just to say that there have been other projects, as Pete indicated, where DEP did not ask for those kinds of detailed specifications. They sometimes question whether bog bridging was appropriate, but when other commissions thought it was fine and voted for it, I don't think they DEP appealed it. So I don't think it's something that they feel strongly about. And other commissions, in particular the Amherst Commission, was happy to have bog bridging as a way of reducing the impacts of the trail overall.
Yep. Okay.
Okay, so if there is no more information that you think of that you'll need, it sounds like we're ready to hear from DEP, and then.
We still wanted you to walk us through the plans.
Yeah, could we just look at those and you could just talk through them quickly?
Oh yes, absolutely. Sorry. Let me see if I can bring up the plans. I had hoped that Dick would be on the call, but. Let me see here. I think I can. Okay, if I can reduce the size a little bit. So what we're looking at here is the side view and top view of the bog bridging. So you can see the 6x6 sleepers, which are each 2 feet long. That the decking, the 2x10 pressure treated decking planks will sit on.
Is that 6x6? Is that the one you said you were going to change?
No, we're changing those on the small bridges.
Oh, okay.
But the bog bridging will definitely be 6x6. This is what we generally use. And then each of the sleepers will be secured to the ground with 24 inch long rebar that we pre-drill and pound the rebar through the sleepers at different angles, so it's not going to move. And I think that any questions about this design?
No.
That is currently, you can see where the bank width is on the lower side view. The top of bank here and here, I think, are 10.5 feet on the shorter bridge and 11.5 feet on the larger bridge. And we're going to 12 feet on the shorter bridge and 14 feet on the slightly longer bridge. The width will be 3 feet, which is the same as the present bridges. The decking will be 2x6 with spacing in between so that light and water can get through. And the stringers will be 2x10s with short ramps at each end to make it easier for people to walk without coming up that step. And Andy asked the other day whether we would put a surfacing that would prevent slipping. And I think we can do that. So, and this will be also anchored, these will be anchored with rebar.
Okay.
Then the third picture is the stairs, which will be built on these 4x6 posts with, and that will have a railing. And the treads will be, we're going to be able to use white oak rather than pressure treated. This says pressure treated. So assuming we have enough of the white oak, we have some from a previous project. It will be one or the other, but they're comparable in durability. So it's a pretty simple structure, and it gets us up that that 6-foot rise without damaging the slope.
Okay.
So any questions about any of those?
No.
No.
I do remember that one of you was going to check with the town administrator about ADA compliance.
Yeah, I can talk about that. Well, first of all, I wasn't able to reach anybody from Kestrel to talk to them, but I looked back in my notes, and it's my understanding that they put in the conservation restriction that they might want to put in a platform for like a tent platform or a wildlife blind. It was kind of open as to what it could be, but a place where a group of people could come and do like a school group or a scouting group could come and sleep over or do a educational thing. That was put in the CR, I think not because they were planning to do that right away, but so that it would be open in the future if they wanted to develop something like that, it would be permitted. I talked to Brian Domina just to ask him, if they did build something like that, what would the Conservation Commission's responsibility be as far as ADA compliance? And he said, I don't know, I'll have to get back to you. So that's where we are with that. But it's nothing that we need to worry about right now anyway. It's just something to think about down the road, maybe.
Yeah, we would want to, and I think Kestrel would want to leave the door open to, at some point, making it more accessible, and probably not wheelchair accessible because of the terrain, but maybe equipped with railings and a wider decking on the bog bridging. But that becomes a much more expensive project, so we're not equipped to propose that at this point.
Any questions on that?
No.
Nope.
Okay. Sharing if you've seen what you need to see here.
Yeah, so I think we have all the information we need for now.
Wait from Brian and I guess DEP.
What was that?
I guess we'll just wait to see what we hear from the town administrator and from DEP, see if we get from that.
Well, I don't think Brian's answer is anything we need right now.
Yeah.
It's something to know for the future. We don't need it for this project.
Yeah.
So I think the next thing would be to vote on continuing this to our September meeting. All right.
Can I ask a question? I'm trying to type the minutes as you guys meet. You talked about breaking this up into three components. When I started typing, I ended up with four. So I'm wondering what the three components are from your point of view.
Oh, right. Are you counting the two bridges as two separate things?
No, it's bog bridging, boardwalk, bridges, and stairway.
We already approved the boardwalk.
Okay, so the boardwalk is not changed?
That came under the early order of conditions. That order allowed two sets of raised bridging. We canceled one of them, but the other one is still proposed, so that falls under the earlier order.
Okay, that answers my question. Thank you. And I would just point out that even though you don't have all the information you need to make a decision, this is a good time for you to raise any concerns that you might have or to request any additional information between now and the next meeting.
Okay. I can't think of any additional questions. Does anyone else have additional questions?
Can't think of anything else.
I'm all set.
All right, are we ready to vote on continuing?
So.
All right. Those in favor of continuing to the September meeting, say aye. Ann?
Aye.
George?
Aye.
Andy?
Aye.
And I also vote aye.
Can you remind us the date and time? Are we at 7 o'clock on September
15th? 7 o'clock, the third Wednesday. What is that?
Which is 15th. The 15th?
Yep. September 15th.
September 15th, yes. Can't hear you, Pete.
Somehow you just go mute all of a sudden.
Hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, well, thank you. And we'll be
so you can be first on the agenda. So I don't think we have anything else, Scott, do we? For September?
For September, no, you're first on the agenda, yes.
Okay, so 7:05.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Pete.
Thank you.
Thanks, Pete.
And we, if you need to put it in the minutes, Scott, we had our site walk on Sunday.
Okay, got it. Thank you. So then the last thing on the agenda is just, well, I mean, there are a couple of last things, but approval of the minutes from our August 4th meeting. So if anybody read the minutes, does anybody have any corrections or concerns?
I read them and I do not have corrections or concerns. Ditto.
All right. All in favor of accepting the minutes, George?
Aye.
Monty?
Aye.
Ann?
Aye.
Andy?
Aye.
I vote yes as well. Thank you. We don't really have any mail to speak of since our last meeting, so we've essentially reviewed the nothing that is our mail. The last thing is just updates and other news or whatever it's called, but I don't really have any updates that I can think of, but if anybody has questions or has observations, this is your opportunity to share it.
Do we have someone else on the meeting who may have questions or issues to bring up?
We have one other person.
Yeah, I see a name, G. Michael Dobbs. Are you there? Are you interested in speaking?
No, I'm a reporter. I'm sitting here listening to you guys.
Oh okay. Okay. I'm sure I must have just woken you up.
No. I'm publishing, so this will be on our new Hadley Amherst edition.
Okay. All right, so updates and other business. Anybody have anything to share?
No.
All right, well, in that case, we're gonna have to have a short meeting. I know that's heartbreaking for all of you. But with that then, I guess the meeting is adjourned until our September meeting on the 15th. Chances are we'll have other site visits between now and then, but who knows? So thank you very much, everybody. And have a good evening. And is everybody going to the Green River Festival this weekend?
I'll be working.
Of course you will. I'm planning to go. I'm hoping it's going to stand as far away from everybody else as possible and listen to the music, but we'll see.
Well, you should stop by my tent and say hi.
I will.
We'll be behind the bathrooms.
Okay. I'll kill two birds with one stone one of those times. Not a kidney stone, hopefully. All right. Enough of that.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night.